knows what he's doing. He's taking advantage of everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, good to have you with us live on Nitro. Ronnie Piper.
Diamond Cutter from the top rope.
He calls that the Diamond Death Cutter, and he's been looking for the opportunity to use that variation.
And he beat him with it. Didn't count 10 on that one. Diamond Dallas is your winner.
And they are standing here in Memphis.
They really are, and that was an awesome move. And
see what I just said? He is setting his opponents up to make mistakes. That's the mark of a main eventer. That's the mark of a guy going to get hit with a pipe.
Look at this.
See ya.
There, no, you stay here. They are daring him
almost to come out of the ring. Look, they have their pipes.
And you never know where the rest of them are.
They have stolen the belt. They have lied. They've attacked Luger. They have made their impact in this show. And it's almost as if they're waiting on Diamond Dallas. And for the first time ever, you are taking a look at a man who is scared. The first time I've ever seen fear in the eyes of DDP. And why not? They've got weapons, for crying out loud.
And we've already seen what happened to Lex Luger, who was laid out in the back earlier tonight as a result of that attack by Nash and Hall.
And they're not going to forget exactly what Diamond Dallas did to them just a few short weeks ago. If you remember, he cost them some big, big embarrassment.
It's probably going to be payback, at least as far as the outsiders are concerned.
Yeah, he had to realize this, guys. He had to realize that when he put the Diamond Cutter a few weeks ago at the Superdome in New Orleans on Scott Hall, that payback would be coming. Oh, wait a second. Our cameras have spotted Sting.
And that is Sting.
That is Sting. Make no mistake about it. The world knows the difference between Sting and the bogus NWO Sting.
And if it's the Sting we know he's carrying a ball back.
Hall and Nash are motioning for Sting to come down and join them.
And there's the Macho Man, Randy Savage,
who Eric Bischoff will not let into WCW.
And I think maybe Dallas sees, he's looked up in the stands. I don't know who he sees, but he's going up towards the stands apparently. Or is he? No, he's gone to get a chair.
He's fighting fire with fire. That's all he can do. He don't know if he's surrounded. He don't know where to put the wagons in the circle or not.
That's a good point. Is Sting out here?
Look at the color Savage has on now.
Is Macho Man, are they all out here? Is he being surrounded on four sides here?
But you notice Savage and Sting are not standing side by side.
No, they're on apparently on like on opposite sides of the Mid-South Coliseum here. And they are standing there. Is Savage gone? Apparently the Macho Man is gone.
It disappeared into the crowd.
Now, why didn't they come to the ring and do a number on Page? Because he had a chair?
There's Savage.
Because Savage is in the stands? Because Sting's in the stands? There's a reason. Something's going on
here. Something is up.
Don't touch that dial.
Boy, what a stalemate we have had here. And Diamond Dallas wields a chair, stands firm in the center of the ring, and a smart move by DDP to make sure Hall and Nash are leaving before he goes anywhere.
But you notice Page didn't leave. He didn't run. He stood there like a man.
And Piper is coming still. Stay with us. Live.